Hey everyone, and welcome to my kitchen. So today, I haven't made this recipe for a long time, and so this is actually a different recipe that I found that is similar, but I'm having troubles to find the original recipe that I like. It is the honey nut bread. So here's the ingredients, and it's made in the bread maker. So, here you see the different colors of the flour. I've got 2 cups of whole wheat flour and 2 cups of all-purpose white flour measured here. And then I'm gonna need 2 tablespoons of honey. And then I'm gonna need 2 tablespoons of butter. And then I have here 1.5 teaspoons of salt, and I have here 2 teaspoons of yeast, quick rise yeast. And later I'll put in 2 tablespoons of the skim milk powder, and I have here, I'm gonna need 1/2 cup of sunflower seeds, not the entire bag, just 1/2 cup. And then I'm gonna need 1/2 cup of the sliced almonds. The almond is gonna give it a very aromatic flavor when the bread is being baked and stuff. And make sure you use the sliced almonds, not the whole almonds. It's just easier for the bread machine to work with. So, and also we're gonna need 1.25 cups of water, which I will put in later in the video. So if you don't have a bread machine, as I say, you can use these exactly same ingredients and then just use the usual way that you make bread to make bread. So we can get started with the recipe here. So now we simply layer the wet ingredients, the water, the butter, the honey into the bread pan, because the honey is sticky, so I'm not really gonna bother with the measuring spoon. I'm just gonna squirt it in so we can get started with that. So next, we can simply add the flour, the salt, and the yeast. Make sure the yeast is in the very top, away from the water. So now, for now, this is all the work we have to do now, and we just press the dough setting. We add the nuts in later when the dough has been formed. This is because it just helps to make sure everything sticks well together. So when we're back, we're gonna put in the nuts. So now my dough is formed nicely like that, and it's not sticking to the pan. And so you may need to adjust with water and flour and use this to keep it from sticking to the side and keep everything well mixed. Now we can add in the nuts that I have measured here. So this is what it looks like when everything is mixed in. At first, when I poured in the nuts, you might think I'm crazy, but the paddle does its magic and works everything into the dough very well. So everything will be all well mixed inside. So as you can see, it's doing that now. So when we get back, when the dough is done, I'm going to be baking it in the oven. So I'll show you the finished dough when it's done. So now my bread is now done, the dough, and as you can see, it has risen up quite it has risen up quite considerably. So now I'm going to transfer it into this loaf pan, and I spread it down with some oil. And so what we're going to do next is we're going to let it rest, cover it in a warm place for half an hour before we put it in the oven to bake it. So now my dough is now resting here. This is the clean cloth and rest for half an hour. And when we get back, you can see how much it has risen. And then it will be ready to bake. So half an hour later, the bread is raised very ginormous size, very huge. And so now we're going to place it into a preheated oven, 350 degrees to bake. So now we're going to put this in the oven and we'll be back in half an hour. So now this bread is now done and it smells so good. And to test if it's done, you just tap it with the knife. And it makes a nice deep sound. Like that. So now I have to let this cool off and I'm gonna show you a slice later.